to the Mid-Ohio Rock Show. I'm Tommy Barnes, and I got to tell you, it's awful nice to be in a t-shirt, kind of tan, and a pair of shorts, hanging out with the one and only Tim Corwin and my buddy Ronnie Hughes. Welcome to, I guess, Ronnie, the third season of the Rock
Show. Third season, Mid-Ohio Rock Show.
We're actually out here at the Richland County Fair in August. Nice night out here, blue skies. Behind us, the stage is all set for what's going to be just one hell of a show. We've got Ohio Express. By the time you see this, you've probably, hopefully, been here and actually seen this.
Yeah, so we
want to introduce Sir Timothy, if you will, Tim Corwin. A lot of you folks know Tim from the bucket seat down in Lexington, but more importantly, we know him for the music.
Rock and roll.
The rock and roll, absolutely. Yeah. Ronnie.
So, tell us from the beginning, Sir Timothy New Orleans.
How it started? Okay.
Yeah. He was born in a little shack, born in a basket,
and down by the river.
I remember this part.
Okay. Yeah,
right. Well, you know, it was a British invasion, and it was Jim Fahler and I had started this band, and we found out about Dean Cashman and Dale Powers in Mansfield, and we thought we could make a band with these guys. And here I was at home practicing with pots and pans and butter knives and on the drums, and we had to come up with a British sounding name. We thought, well, it can't be Sir Dale, Sir Jim. Couldn't be Sir Dean, so we go, oh, Sir Timothy, that sounds right. I'm the guy in the back, you know, in the visit drummer. And so that's how we named it as a British takeoff, is that Sir thing, so we became, at the beginning, Sir Timothy and the Royals. And stuck with that, and ironically, the magic of the band is being able to stay together. And we were able to accomplish that, and within a couple of years, and that was it, my sophomore on up through high school. By our senior year, we were pretty much avidly playing every weekend, mainly in Columbus. Battle of bands down there, and cleaned up on them, and over a year of that, got recognized by an agency out of New York, took us away, named us Ohio Express, and I was in a so.
So here we are, here 40 years later.
40 years later, we're still going. I put in Grecian gray to look cool.
This is the Mansfield Music Hall of Fame Spotlight. In this episode, we would like to pay tribute to those who have contributed to the local music scene and have passed on to the Jam Night in the Sky. Here is the memoriam list as seen on the Hall of Fame website.
You said you'd never leave me.
You can check out the Hall of Fame at momhof.info. This has been a Mansfield Music Hall of Fame Spotlight.
Ronnie and I both, you know, we're all somewhat in the same age group and stuff like that. You think about music then, music now. Did you ever have any, like, crazy-ass endorsement deals back in the day? You know, they kind of, I don't want to say bubblegum companies, but I can't help myself but ask a stupid question like that.
You know,
I mean, then versus now is a whole lot different, obviously.
Yeah, we did one thing, though, for the Pontiac Motor Division on the B side of Triumphs. Song called Firebird, and that was 68, and it was right after Yummy was in heaven. And the management knew that Chewy, that was it. Chewy was going to be the next actual hit they're going to put out. But they told Pontiac Motor Division the B side, Firebird, was going to be this hit. And they gave us like $250,000 and went up to Detroit, took pictures hanging on a train, all that stuff, and then they never made it the A side. We were supposed to get a free Firebird. Our parents got their choice of whatever Pontiac Division car they wanted. And, of course, they got took on that one. But the song's great. And, matter of fact, we're going to play that song the 25th at the car show.
Awesome. You know what you should have done with Chewy is figured out a way to get hooked up with George Lucas when Star Wars was coming out. You'd had yourself a hell of a theme song.
Yummy went into Fear the Woman in Las Vegas, Vietnam, The Simpsons. It's made a lot of touch to the shows.
You kept track of it then? Like that over the years? Some of the media things that it's had
to on. I have a friend who takes care of all that. I can't remember all of it. But yeah, we do have a record of it. It's everywhere. Yummy sold to 8 million records in Japan alone in 68. Yeah.
And now it's an asterisk.
He brought up the remote.
You know what? It seems to me as we can maybe come current here. Was it earlier this year, you guys' new album and the single Goody Goody? Tell me about that one as well.
What we did with this was we wanted to have a demo for just basically to keep to put on in our pocket of cards to get into a management in this area or an agent. We are with Mars Talent, but we're not exclusive. And that's Wendy, the princess. She's in Florida and Jersey. And she puts me into like Vegas, and I've got a backline in LA that we've been with this one. These guys are, all these years, we put together a really tight band right here in Mansfield, which is the way it should be. And I thought, well, let's make this demo for the agents. And in the meantime, while we're making that, we're recording out of Portsmouth, Ohio. We were called by this record company, Cleopatra, out of Santa Monica, to re-record Scooby-Doo for the cartoon show. So we re-recorded Scooby-Doo, and we had that. That was pretty cool. We kind of put that on YouTube or whatever. And the next thing you know, we recorded the hits over for it. And then the guys are going, well, you know, this is such a cool demo thing. Why don't we put this out ourselves? And I go, wait, we already know. We own a record company. I said, you got the legal department because we're doing songs on this CD that are not just ours. We're doing some Eddie Money, Deep Purple. And I said, let's Robin listen to it in Santa Monica. It was a week later, she came back and said, we're going to put this out. Love it, and they just ran with it. So it's downloadable on iTunes now. If it keeps going okay, like they say, they're going to have it out in physically, like in, you know, Target stores and places like that. But you know, and it's a live recording in the studio. It's not added on to make it embellished. It's really what we sound like. And I go, and then that's what they liked about it. And so that's now you know the rest of it.
Out the official website of Mid Ohio Rock Show at midohiorockshow.com. There you'll find exclusive videos, photos, and a link to our online store. Once again, that is midohiorockshow.com.
We got the big man sitting over here watching this film right now, David Haig, your drummer. Talk about your band right now. Who you got in the band?
Well, Dave's the drummer, and I'll tell you, Dave's the bottom of this band, and he's a man after my own heart. I was the original drummer, and I tell you, I admire him. He's the guy that puts the smack and puts the drive into this band. He's the best in my view. You got Johnny Baker on lead guitar. He's a seasoned veteran. He's got that 60s licks down. He's nothing he can't do. Very tasteful. We got Jeff Burgess on the keyboards with good vocals. He does all the high-end parts in our harmonies. A lot of fill on the keyboard. We got Warren Sawyer on the other side on the keyboards. He's got his vocal, guitar, Rickenbacker work. And then does all the effects on keyboards, like our horns. All the cool, you know, phasing. Guy Hoffman, been through a few bands here in Mansfield. Stumpin' Bouncing Wild Man looks like a real live Yosemite Sam, and he's the bottom of the band and great vocals. And because everybody can sing, we really do material that is really hard to do, that takes vocal work, like Brandy, and you know, it's just good stuff. Rather than one guy up there screaming at himself to death, this band sings.
It's a good thing to have.
You know, there's not many bands around that can sing anymore. See, I brought my bottle of honey back there.
Yeah, I see that. You know, and if I could paraphrase Pink Floyd, wish you were here, but you're not. Ha ha. Anyway, these guys are going to be hitting the stage here for the Richland County Fair coming up in a little bit, and I would imagine we'll see you out and about in the community or somewhere down the road.
Yeah, I'll be out shooting out the streetlights probably later, you know.
He borrowed my pellet rifle because it's got a flashlight on the barrel.
The Lexington police took mine. I got to buy another one.
We got to talk to Mr. Parkinson about that, about giving that back to him.
Okay. Yeah. Well, I do know him, as a matter of fact. He's a friend of the family, the mayor, yeah.
Yep. Ronnie, any last closing words before we shut this down?
Thank you.
My pleasure. I had a lot of fun doing it.
Tim Corwin, folks of the Ohio Express, make sure you check him out. I'm sure you got a website, and our producer is probably going to put it right down here for us.
Yes.
Whatever it is. We'll ask him and find out.
Do you have a web?
We don't know.
Later.
Here it is. 1968. Our single, Chewy Chewy.
Steak is done.